This Bambu Lab P1S is an amazing printer, but its stock lighting, not so much. Today, I'm upgrading it with a bright, clean, and easy to install lighting setup that makes monitoring prints a game changer. Let's get started. While the Bambu Lab P1S does include a built-in light, it is quite dim. This does make it quite difficult to see what's going on inside the printer. Whether you're just trying to do general monitoring or doing some simple maintenance tasks, it's quite dark in there. So if you ever struggled to get a clear view of what's going on inside your printer, you're not alone. Thanks to a free file and some cheap LED strips, we can upgrade one of the worst aspects of the P1S. The new lighting will also provide the following benefits. Better visibility if we're working inside the printer. No more struggling in the dark trying to perform maintenance. Improved time lapses. Hopefully with the better lighting, we should also get some improved time lapses. With better lighting, it's easier to check on the prints via the internal camera. I opted for USB powered LED strip lights, mainly so that I can plug them into my Big Tree Tech Panda power module. Say that three times fast. This allows me to turn the lights on and off through the module, giving me extra control over my setup. To complement this lighting upgrade, I decided to print a custom riser. I found a fantastic file over on MakerWorld that's gonna suit my needs well. Since I mainly print with PLA and PETG, having proper ventilation through the top allows me to keep the door closed. At least that's the plan. To take things a step further, I printed this riser in PLA transparent green from Sunlube. This is just gonna take it up an extra notch and hopefully it's gonna make it look super awesome. Proper ventilation is crucial when printing with PLA and PETG when you're dealing with an enclosed printer. It helps with temperature regulation and can help prevent heat creep from potentially clogging up your extruder. Now what you've been waiting for most, let's go ahead and get this built up with the lights attached so we can test this thing out. This particular file prints in four sections with these little connector pieces. Building this should be fairly easy as long as you get everything laid out correctly. You just take these and slide them in to connect the two pieces. Next up, we're gonna go ahead and install the lights. Now, there are some more files that I'd actually like to check out to upgrade my X1 Carbon. But these files may not actually fit on my build plate and require me to have a larger printer. But since I don't have a larger printer, I could use the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. Once I find the riser that I want, I can upload it onto their website, choose the materials and color, and have it shipped straight to my door. This allows me to print the design in a single piece for that extra durability. Thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video. Just kind of fall straight through. I let my son do that and that might've been a mistake. Like that. Here's with the lights off. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the lights on. And it's better, but I'll be honest, it's definitely better, but these lights do really suck. I'm going to be swapping these out for much nicer lights. Apparently you can go too cheap with your LED choices. These are too cheap. I will put these down in the comments below just to let you know not to buy these ones. Now I have to go searching to try to find some better LEDs for this. If you have any suggestions, drop them down in the comment below so I can go find some better lights because these suck. You know, just for some comparison's sake, this is the P1S with the new lights that are just not great. Now, if we come over to my X1 Carbon that I've done a video on before, the lights on these are significantly better. These, not so much. Now, unfortunately, the lights that I put on here are just awful. They're definitely not bright enough. So I went back to the drawing board and I went with the same brand that I've used before, except they actually make some that are USB powered. Let's go ahead and swap these out and see if this is a lot better. I'm not gonna make you rewatch this. Let me just go ahead and get these installed because it's basically the same thing. And we'll see if it's any better. Now that we've got the new lights installed, let's see if these are in fact brighter. Ooh, that is looking a lot better. Let's see if I can turn up the brightness at all. And they are in fact going up. Wow, okay, so that is significantly better than those previous lights that I was using. Now you can really see inside this tinted glass and it should make for some better time lapses. Let's put this to the test and see how it does. With this lit up interior, performing maintenance inside is going to be tremendously better. We definitely knock that off the list. Now let's see how the time lapses look. I think the time lapses look a bit better in my opinion. What do you think? Let me know down in the comments below. And now lastly, let's see how easy it is to monitor prints with the extra lighting. I think it is a lot easier to monitor prints with this extra lighting. I think it definitely is a little bit easier to see inside and see what's going on. Now, if you're interested in trying this out, I have included links to the free riser and the LED strips down in the description below. This affordable and simple upgrade makes a pretty big difference. With the better lighting, I should be able to inspect the prints a little bit easier. While this upgrade was huge, there is a lot that can still be done to this printer, and you should check out this video right here where I take this printer even further with these 5 free upgrades.